Hey everyone, it's Jenny at JC Cards. In today's video, I'm going to be showing you how you can combine heat embossing with turnabout stamps. Turnabout stamps are ones that you flip around three times and create backgrounds. I'm going to be using this rainbow turnabout stamp. They're from Concord and Ninth, and this is actually my second attempt at doing it. Heat embossing a turnabout stamp is not actually that easy, and I've got some tips for you that I learned the second time round. So what you're going to see here is my second attempt at doing it, and hopefully therefore you're going to be able to do this first time. My first recommendation is to make sure you have the jig. That was the first piece of clear plastic that I showed you. It helps you line up your stamp perfectly, but it also means that you can replace your cardstock after your heat embossing each time in almost the exact right position. And it's really, really important therefore that you do that, otherwise your pattern is not going to work out. So I'm using the turnabout jig. I've placed it in my Misty down in the bottom corner, and then I'm using this rainbow turnabout stamp. So it comes with this sheet of acetate that is actually your guide for placing your stamp. I like to apply my stamp over this guide, so the background is facing up, the flat piece of the stamp is facing up there. I'm doing it on a piece of white cardstock so I can see better, and I'm lining up those rainbow arches over that acetate. Once I've got it applied, I can move my card out of the way, and then I'm going to line up the center of that cross over the center of the cross on the jig. Push down my Misty, pick up the stamp, and then I can remove that acetate. You'll see that I've still got the jig. You can just about see it on my Misty in the background. Now I've got a piece of cardstock here. This is 4.25 by 5.5. I'm going to apply it to my jig with some temporary adhesive. And the reason the jig itself is so important is it has these little notches at the top where you apply your cardstock in each corner. So you can't quite see on the video, but I'm lining up my cardstock into those little corners that are engraved onto that jig. I'm then going to use a powder tool because I'm going to be doing some heat embossing and I don't want my embossing powder sticking where I don't want it. So that will remove the static cling. I'm applying it all over, and what you'll see is in the top right hand corner is a number one. A number one, that's really important to remember. So I'll come back to that in a little bit. So I've inked up my stamp. I've used Wow embossing ink. I'm going to do that a couple of times, and then I'm going to remove my cardstock. Use my good old tried and tested coffee filter, and I'm going to be heat embossing it in primary apple red. I've got the super fine here. I actually don't recommend that for these more thick lines. It's actually better off using just the regular grade embossing powder. I did have to do this a couple of times. And I'm just going to apply this down all over my cardstock, and then I'm going to use my Wow dual heat tool to heat it up. And once it's melted, I'm going to let it cool just slightly, and then I'm going to reapply this back into my jig, lining up those top corners exactly with the little notches on the jig itself. That one is still in the top right corner. I did just fold my Misty lid down there just to make sure the stamp's still lined up, because this particular turnabout stamp looks quite similar depending on which way you hold it up. I'm then going to turn it one time. So that's 90 degrees. So you've got a number two in that top right corner. I inked up my stamp again with Wow embossing ink, and I did apply a powder tool, and then I'm going to heat emboss it again. I'm pulling it up each time. Remember that adhesive is on the back of my cardstock. And this time I'm going to put a little notch just with a pen, but you could use a pencil, just in that top right corner, what was originally the top right corner, just so I don't forget which corner lines up with the number one. Which corner lines up with the number one. So at the start when you do this, I recommend adding a little mark just in the top right corner, and it will remind you which corner lines up with the number one. I'm then going to come in and heat emboss with, this is Copacabana. I think it's discontinued now. There is another color, I think it's melon, that's very, very similar. Now you see I flipped my jig back. I've got a number one back in the right hand corner again. This is how this is different to when you stamp with a jig. Every time I'm going to line up that marked corner with the number one before I flip it round. So in this time I've turned it round twice, so I have a number three in the top right corner. This is the only difference between stamping and heat embossing, because of the fact that you're removing your panel each time in between stamping. you do need to remember where you started off, and I just find it easier to put that little mark, go back to number one, then turn it once, turn it twice, and then eventually turn it three times, as you'll see in a minute. For this third stamping, and again, I did use a powder tool in between, I'm using the Rose Glints all over the cardstock again. I love the way these colours all go with each other. What I was going for was a kind of off coral red, off cream kind of looking rainbow. So I haven't gone with a full bright primary rainbow. I just wanted to go for a more like, I guess it's an ombre, coral ombre rainbow. And I've heated that up again with my heat tool. And then you'll see I'm going back again to the number one, lining up my corners with those notches on the jig that you can't quite see on the video. And then I'm going to turn it all the way back to number four in the top right corner to finish my stamping. I'm going to ink it up, stamp it again the last time. And really what worked for me on this go round versus the first time I tried this was that little mark, making sure I did that little mark in the top right corner that lines up with the number one and going back to the number one each time. Also, be very careful and make sure that you line up the top corners of your panel exactly the same each time, particularly with this turnabout stamp. If you don't get it lined up right, those arches cross with each other and you end up with a bit of a not an ideal rainbow arch, let's put it that way. So I'm going to keep this really clean and simple. I've die cut my panel with a stitched rectangle die from Simon Says Stamp. I've applied that with some foam tape onto a white panel of £110 Nina Solar White cardstock. For my sentiment, I'm using the Darling Petals Turnabout, which I am going to choose one of the sentiments from that heat embosser in opaque bright white embossing powder onto black cardstock. And then I'm going to heat that up and then trim down that panel, pop it up on another strip of foam tape just into the center. And I left it at that, kept it clean and simple. This approach, this technique works with any of the turnabout stamps with Concord and Ninth. And you can do this with any colors of embossing powder. So lots of possibilities. And that finishes it from me today. I hope I gave you some tips and tricks for using your turnabout stamps with heat embossing. I've got loads of heat embossing videos. Be sure to check out my playlists, and here's a couple of them that you might enjoy. Also, be sure to head on over to the Wow Embossing YouTube channel, which I've linked to in the description box below. This video first appeared over there, and there's tons of other heat embossing videos that you might like. Have a wonderful day. Bye.